on my bullet, not you.
That was it? I'm good. I was in the Air Force. Sorry about that. This concludes our service. The burial will be at 1 p.m. Here's what I'd like everybody to do. This is friends and family. I want everybody to stand and hug somebody beside you, tell them that you love them. So let us all, I'll dismiss in prayer, then we'll close. Father, you have blessed our hearts by allowing us to be drawn together today, not for the sake of burying a loved one, but the fact that we're a family, and that doesn't matter what struggles are placed ahead of us, doesn't matter what difficulties there are, we can get through them. Our Savior was faced with difficulties, and he got through them, and so did. If we look at all the patriarchs of the Old Testament, we look at all of the apostles, all of the people in the first church, there's not a soul that hasn't suffered setbacks and difficulties and disease and dying. So, Father, from that we gain strength and we move forward knowing that we have a Savior that loved us and that he didn't build this body to last forever, but he did build a soul that would last eternity. Thank you so much, Father, for this place and allowing us to be here. I thank you for our United States Navy. I thank you for this chapel. I pray that every man, woman, boy, and girl that ever enters this place will be blessed abundantly. And it's in Christ's name that I pray. Amen. And in this vision, he can see angels ascending and descending all night long. These angels are coming and going. And in this vision, he hears God speak. And in verse 16, we find this. Jacob woke up suddenly and thought, the Lord is in this place, and I didn't even know it. I'm afraid that there are times in our life that we're in the presence of God, and we don't even know it. Everywhere we look around us, we see things that should remind us that this is God. And that it is in this place. I'm convinced that there are times, like on Sunday mornings, we get up and we find ourselves running late. We can't find our socks, can't find our shoes. This isn't iron. The children didn't do this. We get caught up in traffic. We find a hard place parking when we get here. We're trying to run back and forth to get things set up in Sunday school. We visit with good friends. And we go home feeling on top of the world because we've had a good experience. We've laughed and we've joked. But I'm afraid that sometimes the obvious thing that made us feel so good is the fact that we were in the presence of God and we didn't even know it. I'm absolutely convinced that this is one of the most important things around the Lord's table. Sitting here right now, we have on this altar in front of us, we have a visual reminder. Right here in front of us is the body and the blood of our Lord, and it's real. We can fix our eyes on it. It is in this time of our meditation that we can fix our heart and our expectations on who Christ is. We can remember his suffering. We can draw in our mind the agonizing picture of him being whipped and spit on and nailed on the cross. But still, this is the place where we can come to a realization that...
Mark, how much can we haul sticking out of the back of the truck?
As well, weight.
Right there is where I've got to pick it up flat with the crane. But I didn't have headroom in there. I done picked it up.
Right.